Hi everyone, welcome to Geeta's classes. Today we are going to see the last distribution, discrete probability distribution, Poisson distribution. Okay, now let us see the second popular discrete distribution. It is commonly used in the some business applications, that is Poisson distribution. Some examples where the underlying random variable can be well approximated by the Poisson distribution. Let us see. See the number of customers arriving at a store checkout line during a given time, given 1 hour, for 1 hour, 2 hours, like that. And the number of defective items produced in a day in a manufacturing company. If there is a manufacturing company, there will be some defective items can be produced. So defective items, number of defective items produced in a day in a manufacturing company. Then we can see some number of fatal traffic accidents in a city in a particular week, something like that. So all these things are discrete only. All these examples have a notion of discrete events occurring during some unit of time, we can say. So the number of times they occur can be viewed as a random variable, and this random variable can be approximated by the Poisson distribution. Okay, so next we are going to see the definition. So random variable definition, if you see X capital X, as usual, capital X is a random variable. It is said to follow Poisson distribution if it's having its PMF, P of X is equal to X, we can say, or the parameter lambda, P of X comma lambda is equal to, this is important, e power minus lambda into lambda power X by X factorial, where X can take the values 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, 0 otherwise, that is X cannot be negative. So only non-negative values can be assigned for this. Okay, so here note, here X can take the values 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to infinity. It can go up to infinity. Recollect, in binomial distribution, X can take the values from 0 till the number of trials n. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n only we can take in binomial distribution. Okay, and here lambda is called the parameter of the distribution, because it uniquely defines the distribution. Okay, that is why it is called the parameter of the Poisson distribution. Now let us see, we know, now we have seen that it is a discrete distribution, and let us prove that it is a probability distribution. How, when will you say that it is a probability distribution? If the total probability is 1, let us find out that. Sigma x varies from 0 to infinity, P of x come x is equal to x. If you consider this, sigma x varies from 0 to infinity, e power minus lambda into lambda power x by x factorial. Remember, you have to start from e, okay, e power minus lambda. Then that lambda you write, lambda power x, okay, divided by x factorial. E power minus lambda, lambda power x divided by x factorial. Remember like that. If you write in that order, it will be easy to remember. Okay. So now this is equal to, here again you have to remember this series, e power lambda expansion as a series, 1 plus lambda by 1 factorial plus lambda squared by 2 factorial, and so on up to infinity. Okay, so this is equal to, now sigma, if you substitute e power minus lambda, here x is the variable, x varies from 0 to infinity, e power minus lambda is independent of x, so we can take it outside. Now you substitute the value, x is equal to 0, what will happen? Lambda power 0, 1, divided by 0 factorial, that is also 1, right? When you substitute x is equal to 1, lambda power 1 divided by 1 factorial, plus when you substitute x is equal to 2, what will happen? Lambda squared divided by 2 factorial, and so on. What is this by definition? This is e power minus lambda into, already we have, and this expansion is nothing but e power lambda. So e power minus lambda plus lambda, which is e power 0, which is equal to 1. Now we have proved that it is a probability distribution. And we know by definition, e power minus lambda into lambda power x, x is taking only positive values. Therefore, this cannot be negative. So probability function p of x is greater than or equal to 0. And we have proved that sigma x varies from 0 to infinity, p of x is equal to x is equal to 1. Okay. So now we can we say that this is the PMF of probability mass function, because it is a discrete distribution. This is a probability mass function for the Poisson distribution. Now let us see the constants of the Poisson distribution. We can say first let us find out the mean of the Poisson distribution. Now as usual, what is the mean? By definition, mean is equal to E of x, right? E of x is equal to sigma x varies from 0 to infinity x into whatever is here, we'll write here. So x into p of x, right? So what is p of x? Let us write the definition. Sigma x varies from 0 to infinity x into e power minus lambda, lambda power x by x factorial. Always you follow that order so that you can remember easily. E power minus lambda into lambda power x by x factorial. Okay. So now e power minus lambda can be taken outside. What will be there? Sigma x varies from 0 to infinity x into lambda power x divided by, this x factorial can be written as x into x minus 1 factorial, right? So this xx will get cancelled. See, for example, if it is 5 factorial, you can write 5 into 4 factorial. Similarly, 5 into 4 into 3 factorial, that is x minus 1 factorial. Okay, so x into x minus 1 factorial. And x will get cancelled. So this is equal to e power minus lambda into sigma x varies from 0 to infinity lambda power x in the numerator divided by x minus 1 factorial, right? So e power minus lambda into, now you substitute x is equal to 0. Actually x is equal to 0, minus 1 factorial will not be there, so let us consider it as 1 also. Okay, or you can say lambda power, this is 0, so here we can change it because minus 1 factorial will not be there. Okay, so we have to consider from x is equal to 1 to infinity. So when you substitute in x is equal to 1, you will get lambda power 1 divided by 0 factorial, which is 1, plus lambda squared by 2 factorial, plus when x is equal to 2, it will be lambda squared divided by, no, sorry, this is not 2 factorial, it is 1 factorial. See, when you substitute x is equal to 2, it is lambda power 2 divided by 2 minus 1 factorial, okay, plus when x is equal to 3, what will happen? Lambda cube divided by 3 minus 1, that is 2 factorial, plus so on, right? Now what is common in all the terms? E power minus lambda into lambda is common in all the terms. So lambda into 1 plus 1 lambda I have taken out. So lambda by 1 factorial plus lambda squared by 2 factorial and so on. So e power minus lambda into what is this expansion? E power lambda, right? So this e power minus lambda and e power lambda will get cancelled. So this is equal to lambda. Therefore, mean is equal to mean of Poisson distribution is lambda. Okay. This is equal to n into p actually. Okay, let us see next variance of the Poisson distribution. What is variance by definition? Variance of x is equal to e of x squared minus e of x the whole squared, or mu squared we can say. So this is equal to sigma x varies from 0 to infinity. Whatever is here, we'll write there. So x squared into p of x minus, what is mu? Just now we have found it to be lambda. Therefore, this is lambda squared. So this is equal to sigma x varies from 0 to infinity x squared into, now substitute, what is p of x? E power minus lambda into lambda power x divided by x factorial. Always you remember that order so that it is easy for you. So minus lambda squared. So this is equal to sigma x varies from 0 to infinity. See here, x squared into e power minus lambda into lambda power x. This x factorial I can write it as x into x minus 1 factorial by my lambda squared. So here one x and x squared in the x, and this x will get cancelled. Okay. So what will happen? This is equal to, this we started with variance of x is equal to sigma x varies from 0 to infinity. One x got cancelled, so x into e power minus lambda into lambda power x divided by x minus 1 factorial minus lambda squared, right? Now, this is equal to, now e power minus lambda can be taken outside because it is independent of x. Now, for this x, I am going to make a small adjustment, that is sigma x varies from 0 to infinity. This x can be written as x minus 1 plus 1, okay, x minus 1 plus 1 into lambda power x divided by x minus 1 factorial minus lambda squared, right? So this is equal to e power minus lambda into, now we'll write it as two terms, that is one is x varies from 0 to infinity, x minus 1, that is I'm separating this and separating this, okay? So x minus 1 into lambda power x divided by x minus 1 factorial, right? Plus sigma x varies from 1 to infinity here you write x here also 1 to infinity you can write lambda power x divided by x minus 1 factorial, okay, minus lambda squared, right? So this is equal to e power minus lambda, this bracket is braces, yes, so e power minus lambda into, if you expand here, what will happen? Sigma x varies from 1 to infinity. Here, x minus 1 factorial. So, x minus 1 into lambda power x divided by. I can rewrite this as x minus 1 into x minus 2 factorial. Right? Plus sigma x varies from 1 to infinity. Lambda power x divided by x minus 1 factorial. This e power minus lambda is common for these two terms, minus lambda squared. Okay. So here x minus 1 and x minus 1 will get cancelled. So this is equal to e power minus lambda into sigma x varies from 1 to 2 to infinity, we'll say now. Sigma x varies from 2 to infinity lambda power x divided by x minus 2 factorial. Now see, the first term is x minus 2 factorial plus sigma x varies from 1 to infinity lambda power x by x minus 1 factorial minus lambda squared, right? So, this is equal to e power minus lambda. If you expand this, what will you get? I'll write the expansion. When you write this, when you substitute x is equal to 2, you will get lambda squared into lambda squared by 0 factorial, which is 1, plus lambda cube by 1 factorial, plus lambda power 4 by 2 factorial, plus etc. Plus, if you expand this, what will happen? X is equal to 1. So, lambda by 1, right? Plus lambda squared by, when you substitute 2, it will be lambda squared by 1 factorial plus lambda cube by 2 factorial plus etc. minus lambda squared. So, this is equal to e power minus lambda into, you take lambda squared outside. So 1 plus lambda by 1 factorial plus etc. Plus you take lambda from this outside. So 1 plus 1 by, lambda by 1 factorial plus lambda squared by 2 factorial plus so on. Minus lambda squared, right? So this is equal to e power minus lambda into. What will happen to this term? Lambda squared into what is this series? E power lambda. Plus lambda into, again this is e power lambda, right? Minus lambda squared. That is equal to variance of x is equal to e power lambda, e power minus lambda outside already we have, e power minus lambda. E power lambda is here we have. E power lambda and e power lambda common, I am taking it outside. So e power lambda into lambda squared plus lambda, right? Minus lambda squared. So these two will get cancelled, they will get 1. So lambda squared plus lambda minus lambda squared. Here lambda squared and lambda squared will get cancelled. Therefore this is equal to variance also is lambda. Okay. So for Poisson distribution, both mean and variance are same. Mean is equal to lambda and variance is also lambda. Okay, this is important. Mean and variance of the Poisson distribution is lambda. If you want to find out the standard deviation, root of lambda. Okay. And next we have another important relation that is called a recurrence relation for Poisson distribution. This is again important. We will use for the problem. Recurrence relation for Poisson distribution. So what do you know about PF? P of x is equal to e power minus lambda into lambda power x divided by x factorial, right? What is P of x plus 1 then? In the place of x, if we have x plus 1. What will you know? E power minus lambda. Here there won't be any change. Lambda power x plus 1. In the place of x, you are replacing it by x plus 1 divided by x plus 1 factorial, right? So this is equal to e power minus lambda into, this can be written as lambda power x into lambda, right, divided by x plus 1 into x factorial, right. So this is e power minus lambda. You take this lambda by x factorial separately, you consider lambda by x factorial into e power minus lambda into lambda power x divided by, sorry, lambda by x plus 1 you come write separately. Lambda power x plus 1 into e power minus lambda, lambda power x by x factorial. What is this term? This is nothing but p of x, right? This is p of x. Therefore p of x plus 1 is equal to lambda by x plus 1 into p of x. This is called the recurrence relation of the Poisson distribution. This is called the recurrence relation. Or you can say, if you want, you can say P of x is equal to lambda by x into P of the previous term. It is depending on the previous term. That is why it is called the recurrence relation. Okay. That's all about Poisson distribution. That means we have completed almost the unit 2. Okay. There are some properties that I'll teach after the problems. In the next live class, we will see the problems on Poisson distribution and geometric distribution. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you.